Hello everyone and welcome to this webinar on user insights, our new user-centric module that's been added to our Explorer products. If you have any sound problems throughout this webinar or if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to warn us on the on our questions tab. It'll be on the right of the interface. And let's get started. So first off, I'm Fabien Lucio. I am a product manager on the User Insights module, as I just mentioned. And you have my contact details here if you want to get in touch with anything regarding user-centric information in our solution. Before we jump into the thick of it, I just want to give you a quick overview today of what's the actual benefit of using user insights, why we need it, why you need it, how it's integrated within the rest of Explorer. I want to briefly touch upon the different scopes that the analysis are available in, so the unique visitor perspective against the identified visitor perspective. And lastly, we'll do a quick demo of the interface, what analyses are available to you, as well as two use cases that we've found useful that we'll share with you today. And we'll end on a question answer type format. All right, so first off, what's the benefit behind user insights? Well, there's been a significant increase in the number of devices and marketing channels throughout which users can interact with the brands. There's no such thing anymore as a standard consumer journey which users will follow all the way from a start, an introduction to a brand, all the way to a conversion. You could easily find yourself in a case where your consumers will start on a mobile, they'll migrate through to a website, and then they'll end up converting through an app. So it's no longer sufficient. It's still good, but no longer sufficient to analyze it from a visit perspective. It's important to look at it at more of an aggregated visitor level when analyzing your analytics data. So just a quick statistic to illustrate this. There's been a research done by Criteo last year where they found that 55% of visitors use at least two or more devices before purchasing online. So if you analyze in silo per device, you're no longer going to get a full picture of what's actually going on in terms of interactions with your brands. Secondly, the industry's vision on a brand's interactions with its consumers and the way we analyze the data underlying this has also evolved. So initially we used to look more at a multi-channel type perspective where we were aware that there were different online and offline channels such as websites, brick and mortar stores, call centers, but each had its own strategy. There was no overarching brand's policies or strategies, and users interacted in silo, and this transcended into the way we analyzed it. However, things evolved from that. We moved on to more of a cross-channel perspective on things where we are aware users interact with multiple choice points before converting. However, it lacked coherence and the vision was still limited. We find ourselves nowadays into a more omni-channel perspective where we're really users are behaving in a ecosystem. Users interact with the brand through a multitude of touch points, and it's necessary to develop a common strategy amongst all of your marketing channels in order to, one, communicate efficiently with them, and two, analyze the data. It's important to look at it from this perspective. So this is why ET Internet developed this User Insights module. It's to help you understand how your users are behaving online from this marketing 360 degrees context we operate in. So how did AT Internet do this? So Explorer, as you could have discovered yesterday if you attended the webinar, if not, I'll describe it very quickly. Explorer is your first point of contact with all things exploring and discovering your analytics data. So it consists of multiple modules, the first one being the core analytics module, basic visit level analyses, to which we've added our user insights module, which is seamlessly integrated, and will very shortly add also a navigation and tunnels module, as well as a sales insights module dedicated to e-commerce in the future. So although it's seamlessly integrated, this module, the user insights module, is based on a specific interface and technical infrastructure and engine, which will enable you to focus and explore your users' overarching behavior rather than each individual interaction they have with your brands. So not only is it focused, but also the technology behind it also helps you discover your data more quickly. Another point I wanted to touch upon was the scope at which you could do these analyses. There are two different technologies that you can choose from. Either you can base yourself on a unique visitor scope, so you need to bear in mind that this is based on cookie and device ID data. That being said, your analysis will be limited to the same limits of that technology. So you'll encounter some issues at device level. However, you'll also have a larger sample of users to base your analysis on. On the contrary, if you use identified visitors, so just to remind you what this is, it's based on the information you feed into our interface on how you want to identify your logged in visitors. So the benefit of this is you'll have a certainty of the identity of the users you feed into our interfaces. However, depending on your website strategy and how you make your users log in, it could be that the sample is smaller than using unique visitors. However, just because it's smaller does not mean that you will not get significant results. You can still identify specific behaviors on site that you can then extrapolate to the rest of your users. So it's really a question of choice. All right, so let's jump onto the interface. And I'll show you how all the different analyses. So, there we go. All right, so this is the main interface. This is the core analytics bit and user insights. If your organization's been whitelisted for the beta, your access have also been granted, you will see that the user insights tab shows up here. I'll come back to how to get access if this isn't the case for you guys. So first off, let's jump right in there. There we go. So we've got four different tabs with four different analyses, which we'll discover now. Up on the top left, you're able to select your sites. You can select multiple sites across which you want to analyze your unique visitors. Here you can select your dates. You can also add a comparison timeline. However, you need to bear in mind that as this is a beta, the data is only available from the 1st of January 2017. So if your comparison stems beyond the 1st of January 2017, the analysis won't work. So you need to remember and take this into account. So here I've selected the month of June for analysis. And this is where you choose which scope of visitor you want to analyze from. So we'll select identified visitors on our test on our demo websites. This is the first overall traffic analysis, which will give you a time series or different time series of how your unique visitors are fluctuating and how the behavior is fluctuating over time. Here you have a breakdown of all the different segmentations, I guess you could call it, you could drill into. So if you want to look at traffic source, for example, you have them here. If you want to look at site level, you can have them here and look how they navigate amongst the different sites over time. Look at a device level on this tab. Something of note is you can switch over to a bar chart if you're unable to view it. If you want to just look at volumes rather than over time. Another thing of note, you can also remove, if you find it hard to see a specific line, the information from the graph and add it back in. And that's it. You can add the trend, the mean, the min, and the max in this tab right here. All right. and then aggregate it here if you wish to look at it from an aggregated perspective, for example. There we go. Great, but let's stay on day level. So now let's look at the retention tab, which is the second analysis provided within the user insights module. So the reason why we've added this is because it's great to increase your traffic, grow your traffic, and invest lots of money into your marketing initiatives. However, it's not going to be truly efficient if on the back end you're also losing users and identified visitors. So this analysis will shed a bit more light on how your users are behaving and how they are returning or not to your website. So the way you should read this is that on the 5th of December, 1,863 unique identified visitors visited the website on that day. One day later, 48.6 of these 1,863 visitors came back to the website one day after, and so on. There you go. This analysis is available on completely decorrelated from the time frame. This analysis is available on three different time frames. So either the last 7 days, which is the view we're currently looking at, broken down by day; the last 4 weeks, broken down by weeks; and the last 3 months, broken down by month. So something else of note is that as of tomorrow, you will be able to look at this analysis from three new time frames. So we'll have a last 6 months, last 14 days, and last 14 weeks. Right, so then if we move on to the next tab, the overlap tab, this analysis provides you with a Venn diagram, so it'll give you proportions of how your users are behaving with, or how certain users are behaving with your websites and the crossover amongst those. Again, here you'll find the breakdowns that we had within the overall traffic tab, which will enable us to look at this data from different levels. So here we're looking at traffic sources, for example, which ones users used in order to get to your website. If you're having a hard time reading these bubbles, you can also have the option to remove the proportion. So you have three equally sized bubbles representing your data. The way you should read these numbers, I should add, is that the top number refers to the colored circle in full, whereas the bottom number will refer to just that portion which is unique to this bubble. So for example, here what we're looking at is direct traffic. So there'll be 2 million, almost 3 million users who will be within this bubble, but a portion of those will overlap with the other sources, and 1.9 million of these users will be unique to will come to the website only through direct traffic. This information is also provided in the table under as just another way to visualize it. All right, so let's move on to the last VA, which is our sequences. So not only can we look at proportions of how users are behaving on our website, we can also look into what sequence of events is happening, which is leading to these users accessing your website. So the point of this analysis is to look at it from an aggregated global view. So we'll show you maximum 5 interactions. However, if two actions are similar, so for example, if the two first interactions are search engine interactions, they'll be aggregated within this view. So this does not illustrate two touch points before reaching your website. This is actually, it could be a multitude of them, but they'll have to happen in this this order. Also, something that's interesting to note is that here you can select solely sequences that have converted, and you can optimize your website accordingly, and over time see how this changes. Great, so that's about it for my quick demo of the interface. I'll now just quickly show you two use cases that we've already identified as useful, and hopefully they'll be just as useful for you guys. So first is the conversion rate at the visitor level. So if we head back over into the core analytics, and what's interesting about this use case is that it shows the complementarity and the between the core analytics part of our Explorer module, as well as the need for this visitor perspective. So over this time period, if we look at the conversion rate from a visit level, we'll find out that on average we'll convert 1.17% of visits. So this seems quite low and quite unreassuring at first glance. However, ultimately, if we put it back into context, what we're trying to convert is users. So now what you can do is head over into User Insights in our overall traffic tab. And look at it from an identified visitor perspective. And it turns out that 1.18%, 1.17% is quite low, as we're actually able to convert, once deduplicated and looked at from a visitor perspective, 18.65% of visitors. So that's a much higher rate. And even though this will average, will convert about between 2% and 3.5% of users on each day, we can look here to confirm, over the course of the months, we'll convert 18.65% of our users. So here, that's quite a reassuring number, as we're actually converting a lot more than, a lot bigger proportion than we initially thought. So that's it from my first use case. The second use case is actually stemmed from a question that comes back to us quite often, is what is the, one, evolution, and two, the contribution of a mobile the mobile device within total user path to conversions. So this is something that may have been tricky to do before, but now you can easily do this using User Insights. So if we look at it from a overlap perspective, first off, and we add a segment, I think I've got this prepared, yes. So if we add a segment on devices, and then within that we select mobile phones, we'll notice that the way users reach the site from a device perspective changes significantly. So I'll do that again to show you. If we deactivate it, overall users with no segment will significantly more or more likely to reach the website from a desktop. However, if we segment for our mobile visitors who have at least visited the site once using a mobile phone, it's predominantly through an app or via a mobile website. So you can optimize your website accordingly. And lastly, we can also look at it from a sequences perspective. So if we look at the sites, sorry, traffic sources, for example, we can see that the most common path to purchase, or the most common path to your website, will also change depending on whether or not a mobile visit was included into that conversion, that touch point. There we go. And then you can take actions and change your, optimize your website to take these things into account and change your strategy over your different platforms to really optimize to those mobile users, which are very important to focus on these days. Great. So that's all for my use cases. Just some things I'd like to reiterate. User Insights is available as a beta. If your organization's already been whitelisted, all you have to do is fill out this form and we'll grant you access. Otherwise, if it has not, please fill out this form. We'll add you to our waiting list and grant you access to User Insights as quickly as possible. Please bear in mind that User Insights, the beta, is completely free of charge. And anything that's included within this beta will remain free once we switch over to a V1, a first version of this product. If you guys have any questions, please write them within the questions tab. Let me have a look at what you guys have written. Also, something of note, before I forget, let's do this now. Please, if you have any feedback, do not hesitate to use this feedback button and share any negative or positive feedbacks. Please don't hesitate. This is a direct and live connection, real-time connection to all our product managers within the business, and this will really help us help you really in the end. In addition, you can also find additional content within the knowledge base. You can access it through here. There's a dedicated section to user insights. If this is not something you've done in the past, I highly encourage you you go have a look. Just having a look at your questions. Okay, so first one. How can I analyze user loyalty and frequency of visit? That's a very good question. Very promptly, with not too far away from now, we'll come out with a visits per day and a frequency of days per with visits analysis that will add to this module, to the list of analysis available within the user insights module. Another question. I have access to user insights. How can I give access to my other employees? Please, so if you wish to grant access to other users within your business, please share the link I shared with you. It's also available within the chat. They'll be able to fill out the form, and we'll be able to grant them access on the back end of it. And look at if you have any other questions. Is it possible to define conversion? That's a very good question. At the minute, it's defined as a primary conversion. And this, as I mentioned, this is a beta. With time, we'll add different elements, and this is one element we'll definitely consider adding. It's also worth a note that if you're really looking into conversion, we'll be developing a dedicated e-commerce module called the Sales Insights. Could you show us what is in the campaigns tab sequences, please? Yes, of course. So this doesn't work on this one. I'm using demo websites, so we don't actually have any marketing campaigns attached to these websites. But if you click here, yeah, it won't work. Basically, I can show you off traffic sources. You'll just have the different sequences of campaigns that your users have come across before reaching your website, and it's really interesting as you can select sequences that converted and then look at what marketing touch points users came across before converting, and also in what order before converting on your website. I hope that answers your question. So when will navigation and funnels and the sales insights, please? So I believe that the navigation and tunnels module will have a minimal viable product / alpha available to a selected group of clients, I believe within Q1 or Q2 of 2018. And sales insights will unfortunately take a little bit more time for us to develop, and maybe more around don't take my word for it, but around Q4 of 2018. I hope that answers your questions. Thank you for listening to this webinar today. I hope it helped you answer some of your questions you had around the tool. For those who didn't have access, I hope if you want to get access, and you'll have the link necessary in order to do so. Thank you. Have a great day. Bye.